So today's video is just going to be a short look at how to run BTCRecover on Windows. And while I'm confident that anybody can follow the step-by-step instructions I put in my previous videos to get this running in a safe environment offline in Linux, I'm also aware that some folk are going to just be put off by the idea of using Linux in the first place and may even find themselves doing something even more risky and scammy, such as handing over their seed to the first scam that messages them on Reddit. So I'm providing this, I suppose, as a less bad alternative. But you should consider your seed compromised, and we have an additional last step in this process, which is moving your funds onto a new seed. So like all my other videos with BTCRecover, you will need your 24-word seed, even if it just has errors. You can't simply derive a private key from a public key. You will need to know at least one public address that you've used with that wallet. So what I have here is a clean Windows install with no Python, no nothing, and we're just going to walk through it from scratch. And we're even going to use Edge because we're going to assume you don't even have a proper browser installed. So the first thing we're going to do is just download BTCRecover from the GitHub repository, and all the links for this will be in the description. We'll just download zip. We're also just going to follow the seed recovery quick start guide because you'll see it's pretty much all you need to do. Now that we've got BTCRecover downloaded, we also want to download Python, and it's important to note you need Python 2 for this. BTCRecover doesn't currently work with Python 3. So we basically just want to download the most recent version of Python 2.7 just from the python.org website. We are on Windows, so we'll just download the 64-bit installer. So we've just got our two files we've downloaded, so we're just going to click through and follow the defaults of Python because they all work fine. Alright, so the Python installer has finished, and we can actually just open up Command Prompt. So if you just type in Command Prompt in the search bar in Windows, it'll come up, and that's the one you want. So what we need to do now is to install these two packages that are the same ones that it needs on Linux. So that's CoinCurve and PySHA3. So we can actually just copy that and say pip install, and then paste it, and then hit enter, and it'll just sit there and think about it for a little while it installs them. We've downloaded Python 2 and installed that, and we've installed all the packages we need from pip. So this is the point where you should disconnect your network connection. That might mean disabling your Wi-Fi or unplugging the network cable, just so that if your computer is compromised, it's not going to leak the seed as you're recovering it or when it has. I would advise you not to reconnect your cable until after you have recovered your funds and moved them onto a new seed. So we've got everything else set up, it's time to run BTCRecover. So we can just right click on the file we downloaded from GitHub, say extract all, and we're just going to get rid of this bit of extra stuff at the end and just unzip it straight into downloads, and you'll see why that is in a second. So we just extract that, you can see it here, and just a quick tip, which is to say, don't just double click on the PY file and hope for the best, because when you do that, it'll ask you to select a wallet, it'll ask you to select the type of seed. It will look like it's working, but what it doesn't let you do when you just double click on it is enter a custom derivation path, which means that in a lot of situations, just double clicking on the seed recover file isn't going to be able to recover your seed. So we are not going to just run it from double clicking on it. We're going to run it from the command line. So we can go back to the command prompt we had open before from Python. And by default, command prompts in Windows open to your user folder. So we're just going to go into downloads because that's where we unzipped it to. If I just type in down and hit tab, it'll complete it for me. Now we want to navigate into the folder with BTCRecover, so we'll say cd BTCRecover, and if we hit tab, it'll complete it for me. So once we're in that folder, if we just type in dir, it'll actually list all the different files, and we can just make sure that we are in the right folder by just checking that all the files are there. So let's run a quick demo to make sure everything's working, and that's going to be using this command here that you can copy and paste from the description. So this is just a simple test. It's only looking for one typo, which is a big typo, which means one of the words is wrong, but it could be a valid word out of the BIP39 word list. We're only going to generate 10 deep, and we're using this derivation path here, which is the default SegWit derivation path. So if your address starts with a 3 and you're looking for the first account connected to that seed, then this is probably the derivation path you want. So we're just going to right click, and that pastes it in to the command prompt, and then we hit enter. We don't have a wallet file, so we say cancel. We just have a standard BIP39 wallet. We don't have an XPub key. The one address that we had that we remembered was this one here. And our best guess of the mnemonic is this one here with the error in it in red. where you can see we had size instead of side. That is an easy mistake to make, one letter wrong. So we'll paste that in. And it'll sit there and think about it for about 30 seconds, then find the result. There you go. So that's a single word recover done in just a couple of seconds. And we can see there it has found the error and corrected it. So if you've successfully recovered your seed, then I'd suggest this is the time when you should move your funds onto a new wallet with a new seed. And preferably you should do that before you reconnect this computer back onto the internet, just to make sure that your seed isn't leaked. And there's a number of ways that you can do that. You don't need to go buying a second hardware wallet to do this, and I'll be covering that in videos over the next couple of weeks. Thanks for watching. I hope that was helpful. Hit like if you think that other people would find this video useful, and hit subscribe if you'd like to be kept in the loop about future content I make that helps people stay safe in the crypto space and to recover if they get into trouble. If you have any questions about this video or a topic that you'd like me to cover, just leave a reply.